For NASA's upcoming Artemis missions, we're going to have a long-term, sustained presence on the Moon. In order to do that, we're going to need to access the water. The reason we're focused on excavating and hauling and using the water that can be found on the Moon is because if we can use the local resources, then we won't have to ship tons and tons of those resources all the way from Earth to the Moon. NASA's Break the Ice Lunar Challenge is so groundbreaking, pun intended, because it's going to advance technologies for digging and excavating icy regolith and for transporting those materials in order to support our long-term human-sustained missions. And the lunar environment that these robots need to operate in is very extreme. At the lunar South Pole, it's very dark, it's very cold, and it's a complete and total vacuum. So in phase two, level one of this challenge, what we've asked teams to do is to design a robot on paper and to design a system for excavating icy regolith and transporting that icy regolith on the surface of the Moon. We've been really impressed with all the ideas that we've received in phase two, level one. The teams have really come up with some innovative and really out-of-the-box ideas. We are really hopeful that some of the winners of this challenge will go on someday to fly their robots all the way to the surface of the Moon. And we think that some of the technologies that are invented in this challenge could also be used here on Earth. The winners of level one are going to move on to level two, where they will actually build the robots that they've designed, and then they will test them in simulated lunar conditions, and they will test them for long durations. I am really excited to announce the winners of NASA's Break the Ice Lunar Challenge, phase two, level one. Congratulations to all of the Break the Ice Lunar Challenge Phase 2 Level 1 winners. We look forward to seeing your technologies being used on missions to the Moon and beyond.